I have titled this first module Reconstructing America, and in it we will read post-Reconstruction and pre-World War I texts. And some questions I want us to consider are, what did it mean to be an American, and who was considered an American during this time period from 1865 to 1914? In other words, who could lay claim to these promises stated in the Declaration, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life and liberty and the pursuit of happiness? Who could lay claim to these promises of inherent rights and equality? Certainly not Native Americans, who are being driven off their lands and forcibly assimilated into white culture, or blacks, who are still suffering social and political injustices as they sought to reconstruct their lives post-slavery, or women, who had limited opportunities and wouldn't even get the vote until 1920. So how then can a nation founded on inalienable rights of life and liberty and the pursuit of happiness for all support inequality based on race and gender? The answer is complicated, but one of the ways that any dominant group justifies its abuses of another group is to label the abused as other, as less than, or lacking in some way, and thus not inherently equal at all. In post-Reconstruction America, then, in order to justify inequity in the face of a declaration of belief that all are created equal, we saw the development of an insidious ideology of race and gender, in which Native Americans, African Americans, and women were marginalized and considered other, and not entitled to the rights of citizens. So the point of this section of the course is to read text that will enable us to hear the voices of the other, so that we, in Ambrose Bierce's words, can endeavor to see things as they are, not as they ought to be, so that we can endeavor to understand different perspectives and the fight for equality for all Americans that began almost 150 years ago and still continues today. So get ready to dive in and read some really exciting text by these marginalized voices.